we are always dealing with new hurdles. We're dealing with new hurdles this year with the pandemic, and it always behooves us to have more tools in our toolbox to be adaptable, to be able to be consistent, to self-motivate, to be focused, to have quality practice. And the more that we have that, then we're just more able to rise to the challenge and get all the work and get the best out of the work.
Okay, so you mentioned motivation. I know this idea that I think the hardest thing for everybody, whichever level you're at, is how do you stay motivated every day, every week, every year, on and on and on. And one of the things I talk about all the time is finding the power of why. Why are you doing it? So when I have people work out, I have them write down, why do you want to work out? And usually it starts with, oh, I need to lose a little weight, or I want a little firmer, you know, behind or tummy or something like that. But that is all external, and it's very short term. And so then I say, well, why don't you write down what else? Well, my doctor said my cholesterol levels are too high, or I find that I don't have any sex drive anymore, or I have no energy in the afternoon. And I say, well, why else? And I keep, well, my skin's gotten a little sallow, and they keep going. I don't feel good about myself. And pretty soon you have this long list of why you are getting out and moving your body. And it really has nothing to do with thinner thighs or a tighter tummy. It has to do about your brain function and about your entire life. And that's what I call the power of why. But I know that you have a lot of interesting things to say about this idea of how do you get in the reward, the inside reward, or what do you call it?
The intrinsic motivation or the internal motivation. No, exactly. They do say that having a strong why statement or having your values align with your actions is the surest way to be more consistent. But I was struggling with this, to be honest, when the Olympics got canceled, because he kept having me, okay, we're gonna track our motivations. What's your internal motivation today? What's your intrinsic motivation? That could be, yeah, for the fun of it, for the love of it, just the pure enjoyment of being outside.
Let me get that straight. So it's not like I'm going out to run today so I can take off another second off my time.
Right.
I'm going out to run today because there's fresh air and I'm being with my teammates, or I'm going to...
Exactly. But the thing is, but then I was saying, but actually, am I only externally motivated? Because to be honest, like, I was training for the Olympics. I wanted to do well there. And so it was hard for me to be like, wait, is that, now that this is taken away, do I have other motivations? And I learned about this thing called the justification effect. So we see it when people are paid a lot of money. Even if you start something for like internally motivated, you love your job, you love running, as soon as you have a really big external motivator, like a gold medal or $1 million, people then actually show that they can become less internally motivated. So they almost forget why they originally started. And the answer to that is, it's kind of this idea like where your focus goes grows, right? So if you put your focus on those internal motivations, you like remember why you did these, you can still have the external ones. They can still be important, but you're still focusing. You can be journaling about them, like remembering the internal whys. That will enable you to push through those times when the external rewards aren't there.
So true. It's like, what gets you? I mean, I remember I used to say, now I get paid for helping people exercise,
yeah.
But you know, I would do it for free because I love what I did. I love what I do. And so being paid or not paid is not a factor. It's nice to get paid, obviously, but that's not what's getting me up every day to do what I do. So that's really, really important. So